Tony Trunks from Combined Defensive Arts here again to give you a nice instructional video on a turning kick or round kick. We're doing this from our lead leg today. We will do one off the rear, but we're going to do them in the style of kind of the savate or taekwondo kind of way of kicking, okay? Previous video we did Muay Thai inspired kind of round kick. As I said today, we're going to do more of taekwondo savat, so more of a flicking kick. This is more for your point stopped kind of sparring, but it can be used as a nice little setup with your legs to other combinations as well. So not every technique you throw has to be full power or has to be a knockout shot. Sometimes it's just good to kind of put something in somebody's face or tap their leg in a way that then you can set up other combinations. Okay, so the way we do this one then is we are going to do it off the lead leg to start off. So again, we will start with a nice guard and positioning. Now, the difference with this on the lead leg is, except you're not going to get power this, you're more kind of flicking it out and trying to hit the point on the head, certainly going to that height, or just a flick up to here. So the way this varies from like a Thai kick, where you kind of swing it around like a baseball bat. This one, you point your knee, okay? So you're bringing the up, point your knee, and look at the extension of your foot, whipping out and then coming back in again, okay? So a lot of old point store today, point stop days when to compete, people do come on one leg, doing several kicks off the lead leg, which is what you can do. You can kind of double these up, yeah? And you can various different heights, okay? So posted a recent video on my page about savat, guy did about 20 different kicks off the one leg without pulling it down. I don't have that skill level, but I can certainly do a couple. Okay, so from there, high and then low, okay, down there. So it's quite surprising how you catch people out by doubling up your kicks on the leg. A lead leg's a great one to do it with, okay? So it's the closest tool, closest target, which is a great sort of rule for fighting anyway. So we're just here, let's pick your leg up and you can just tap it in there. Okay, so this could be the inside of the lead leg, yeah, so the simple tap to kind of take somebody's balance, yeah. This will be up here, just a quick pop up to the ribs. Again, if you're doing point sparring, which some people do, some of our kids enter into that kind of stuff, then that's a quick 2 points. Okay, so you're up on your toes, it's just a pick up and hit, okay? Now next, I'm bringing my leg down as quickly as I can, which is important with kicking. You don't want to be out there for sort of like a selfie moment before you put your leg down, okay? You want to come in, kick, and then root that foot down again. So start, middle, and an end of everything you do, like a story, okay? That's each part is equally important. So from here, I'm going to pick that leg, and I'm going to point that knee towards our target, okay? Once we've done that, we can extend our leg, and then we pull it straight down again, and we can go from here, okay? You can do that same sort of flicky kick off the rear leg as well, okay, like this. So a bit different than the Thai round kick, which we discussed the other day. This one, you're just flicking it in and dragging it back again. Okay, so point the knee, kick, and back down again. So not going to be as devastating. Can be that little bit quicker. And again, depending on the sport fighting you're doing, again, because this is sport-based techniques we're using here, so if you are doing this like a point stop thing, you're not trying to get the knockout, semi-contact competition stuff, then these kicks are absolutely fine, yeah? And you can whip these kicks in and move it around and flick it in like so, okay? Nice and quick, okay? Less power, as I said, than the Thai round kick, but equally as effective at scoring points and getting you doing what you need to do. Okay, so again, it's just the pointing of the knee that's the important thing, the extension of the leg, and bring it back. So good practice on these, get your strength in your legs. If you stand and you can just get your body position right, try not to be leaning over too much like this, okay? We can here, and you can just do sort of 10 on one leg, yeah, and then swap that over, do 10 on the other leg, okay? And then when you get the hang of that, you can practice bouncing with them as well. Okay, on the other leg, bouncing. And then once you get the hang of that, then you can practice bounce on the pad and then bouncing across the distance. We set a challenge for the kids the other day in our class. They can go up and down the hall without putting their leg down. I'll give them a fiver. Yet to have anyone do that yet, but it's given them a little bit of motivation to practice. Alright, so lead leg and rear leg, quick flicking kicks, okay? Like I said, nice setup then to open stuff up or take a balance, drop a nice cross on the back end of that if you hit some of those. All right, something to practice, something to look with. Hope you enjoy. Like, share, all those things. Get those wheels of social media turning, and we'll see you at the next video. Thanks very much.